Sony Xperia Z2 is the third iteration in the Xperia Z line of handsets from Sony. So with two handsets already under their belt, the Z2 should be a well-rounded and strong performer. The slab-like design is continued from the original Z. Corners have been softened somewhat to make the device feel less rough in hand. The bold design and the use of glass, front and rear panels with aluminium frame give the Z2 an air of quality that stands out when lined up next to the competition. The IP55-58 rating goes that one step further to make this device stand out. It can withstand immersion in fresh water at a depth of 1.5 meters for up to 30 minutes. All told, the device weighs in 7 grams lighter than its predecessor at 163 grams, but 18 grams heavier than the less premium feeling S5. Is a device over 150 grams too heavy? Whilst the Z2 boasts 4K video recording, it doesn't yet boast a 4K screen. What it does offer is Full HD 5.2 inch IPS display with a resolution of 1920 by 1080 with 423 ppi. Combine this with the improved viewing angles over the Z1, the Triluminous and X-Reality technology, and the result is colours that appear vivid and rich, giving you what is hopefully one of the best mobile viewing experiences. At 5.2 inches, it might be a bit big for some, but if you want the big screen experience on the move, then this is the sacrifice that has to be made. The anti-shatter film included on other devices was prone to attracting dust and scratches. Sony have listened, and it has now been removed on the device, so the addition of a screen protector will be at your discretion. With Android 4.4 KitKat out of the box, no one can criticise Sony for being behind here. It's not stock, but it's considerably closer to this than the likes of Samsung and even HTC devices. These tweaks and apps inevitably add a bit of bloatware to the device, but they can always be hidden or even removed. Of the 16GB onboard, nearer 12GB is actually usable, much better than the 8 or 9GB offered by their Korean counterparts, but a microSD memory card slot exists for those who need it. Being a flagship Sony product, the device is PlayStation Mobile certified, so you can enjoy some of the best titles on the move. Pair up a PlayStation controller, a DK36 dock and an HD TV, and you have an excellent mobile gaming setup. The Z2 is a powerhouse, with 3GB of RAM supporting the 2.3GHz quad-core processor, multitasking is effortless, and lag is not really a phrase you'll be considering when operating this phone. The Z2 sports some interesting additions, of which many have been seen on competitors' devices. Glove mode, as the name implies, enhances the screen sensitivity so that you can use the phone in colder climates with gloves on. Smart backlight control keeps the screen on when you look at the phone, no need to actually touch the handset. Smart call handling allows you to answer a call by bringing the phone to the ear, reject a call by shaking it, and silence a call by turning the phone over. Tap to wake up turns the screen on after a double tap on the display. Do any of these sound familiar? Where once it was common to slide open the notification bar and be presented with notifications and shortcuts, this is now split by a quick settings and notifications tab. It defaults to the notifications, but settings is just a tap away. Shortcuts and their order can all be customized to your liking. A number of small apps are included on the Z2. Press and hold on the running apps key, and at the bottom, you're presented with a list of apps such as a calculator, stopwatch, and sound recorder. These small apps sit in Windows on top of Android and can be moved about on the screen and retain their position on top of Android even as the phone is being used in the background. Only upon closing them will they disappear. As you would expect, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, GPS, DLNA, Miracast, 3G and 4G are all standard, so your basic functions of internet connectivity to music streaming to street level navigation are covered. Use the DK36 magnetic charging dock to charge your device without the need to open the slightly fiddly port covers. MHO is a technology that with the appropriate cable or adapter, you can output the display of the phone to an HD-enabled display. The Z2 is one of the first devices to offer MHL 3.0. This means 4K output from the phone, so the 4K video captured on the camera can be actually output in full 4K Ultra HD rather than the more common 1080p. The current negative at the time of reviewing is that the adapter which actually allows 4K output is not available as yet. Thankfully, the port is backwards compatible, so 1080p output will have to be the norm for now.
There is little in the way of anything missing in terms of connectivity, apart from wireless charging, but you can add this with a wireless charging cover.
It would be unfair to say the audio quality has been bad on Sony devices of past, just not as good as we would like. There are now dual front-facing stereo speakers, which make a massive difference and put it close to the HTC One. Whilst the Z2 was the slightly louder of the two in our tests, it was evident that the HTC was marginally better in audio quality with more realistic tones. The Z2 speakers are a marked improvement and do not dominate the front panel like the HTC One. The undisputed king of the smartphone camera is Nokia Nokia's Lumia 1020. The Z2 sits proudly against the competition thanks to its 20.7 megapixel camera with 27mm f2.0 aperture Sony G lens. The camera is the same one that comes on the Z1 and the Z1 Compact, or so it appears at first. The camera has come under some criticism for not actually producing the quality of shot you would expect given Sony's promotion of its capabilities. The quality of the resulting shot can sometimes be unpredictable on the Z1, but this isn't the case so much on the Z2. Low light shots are where the biggest improvement seems to have been made. There was evidently less noise. Color might seem a little oversaturated for some, but editing of images on Android is infinitely more possible than it used to be. Unlike the standard camera interface on Android devices, Sony have put a lot of work in here. The camera includes many features we have seen before, including Info Eye, Social Live, AR mode, and more. However, the Z2 has a couple of additions to win you over. You now have full 4K Ultra HD video recording. You may not need or want it, but 4K footage scaled down to a 1080p display is better than 1080p footage on a 1080p display, as silly as it sounds. 4K is memory intensive though. Time shift video allows you to shoot video at 120 frames per second, but only in 720p HD. You might not need this on a daily basis, but it is a cool feature and will certainly add some fun and drama to certain clips. There are many creative image types under the creative effect option within the camera. Give your images and video a sketch, nostalgic, vivid, mosaic, and old film tone amongst many more. You're unlikely to regularly jump for those options, but they should be used as they liven up many images. Background defocus is another useful addition, meaning you can simulate a shallow depth of field and add the more artistic flair to your shots. Optical image stabilization is not something found on the Z2, but steady shot looks to give an equivalent effect. Shooting in superior auto mode is going to be commonplace for many. It detects the scene to give the best settings for that. Whilst the advantages speak for themselves, the image size is adjusted accordingly. So to get the full 20.7 megapixel experience, you need to use the manual mode. The dedicated camera key can be held down for quick access to the camera, and the volume keys used as zoom controls. The 3200 mAh battery on the Z2 is 200 mAh bigger than the Z1. There is little difference in the hardware, and further improvements in Sony's stamina battery technology should allow a slightly longer usage time. Daily charges are commonplace on high-end smartphones, but Sony have proven that with stamina mode, this can be a thing of the past, yet more demanding users may struggle to get 2 full days out of it. Sony offer a concise but relevant range of official accessories for the Z2. Rival brands often announce accessories that never make it to market, but Sony appear to ensure that this happens, which is a real positive if you're looking to opt for the Z2. The value of accessories are often underrated. Depending on your market, whether you are buying on contract or SIM-free will all depend on the price. At the time of recording, the Z2 was similarly, if not slightly cheaper than its closest rival, the Samsung Galaxy S5. Sony have yet again managed to produce a device that impresses. Yes, there are some minor niggles, but find me one without any. The Xperia Z2 is a progression on the Xperia Z1, and a good one at that. There are obvious improvements from the screen to the speakers to the camera. Original Xperia Z owners will see a marked improvement, and it's a justifiable upgrade, whilst current Samsung S4 or HTC One owners are left in a position of deciding whether the Z2 offers what you need. You are certainly not going to be disappointed. The smartphone market is more challenging than ever. Whilst the Moto X and G are not up there on specs, they're not far behind and are much cheaper, which makes buyers question whether the extra couple of £100 is worth it. Where 2013 was dominated by massive sales for Samsung, Sony rightfully deserve a considerably bigger slice of that pie in 2014, because the Z2 is an excellent piece of hardware that many will not regret spending their hard-earned money on.